What's going on, everybody? It is Man of Justice 21 here, and today I'm going to be doing a video that was requested by a subscriber. And in that request, he wanted me to show off my video game collection. And, well, I did a count of that, and there's just a little too much. So I'm going to split it up into two parts. This first part is actually going to be my Steelbook video game collection. And I have them right here. So, let's get started. Now, first up is going to be Cyberpunk 2077. Now, originally, I didn't get it with the Steelbook. I actually got this copy for Christmas. And then maybe a month or two later, I saw this at Best Buy. They actually had three different versions of it at Best Buy. So I was like, why not? Because I'm trying to build up my Steelbook collection as much as possible. Now, personally, I really do like the game. But until they fix it, I'm not really keen on jumping onto the game anytime soon. Next up is Borderlands 3. A similar situation to Cyberpunk 2077. The only thing is, I have yet to play this game. This was actually on sale at Target for like $5 or $10, and I said, why not? And I saw the Steelbook at Best Buy as well. So I was like, why not? Next up is going to be Final Fantasy VII Remake. And unlike the other two, I actually bought these at the same time. And in my personal opinion, out of all the Steelbooks I have, I would probably rate this in my top 10 favorite Steelbooks. And as for the game, it's a great game, but the side quests suck. They just suck. Next up is actually my first ever Steelbook, and that is Batman Arkham Knight. Now, just like Final Fantasy VII, I actually got this together, and it was actually with the special edition that came with the Batman Arkham Knight statue. As for the game, well, most people would agree, Arkham Knight is actually not the best one. For me, it's actually my least favorite. Next up, that needs no introduction, the Mass Effect Legendary Edition. This is easily my top 5 favorite Steelbooks. And yes, I did buy them together. I love the trilogy, and I'm so happy I'm playing through it again and doing a better, more high quality stream for you guys, unlike when I first played the game. Next up is another one I bought together, and it's easily my least favorite in the series, or at least bottom two least favorite. Kingdom Hearts 3, and if I have to be honest, not my favorite Steelbook design. It's very plain and very boring, and that's about as much as I can say about that. Next up is actually another one I bought together, and it's actually one of the last ones I bought together, Resident Evil 8. And personally, I really enjoy the game. I'm still trying to figure out if I like it more than Resident Evil 7, but time will tell. And if you guys ever want to start collecting your own video game Steelbook collection, honestly, pre-order from Best Buy, because most of the time, their new games actually come with a Steelbook for free. So, like I said, that's a pretty good deal in my opinion. Next up is another game. And technically, I bought this together, but technically, I didn't. Because I didn't pre-order this game, and the Steelbook was available at the same time I bought the game. So, technically, I didn't get it together. But you catch my point. Marvel's The Avengers. This is easily in my top 10 favorite Steelbooks I own, just for the cover alone. Like, it looks amazing. And as for the game, I haven't played it since I finished the story. Well, since the first part of the DLC with Kate Bishop. I really enjoyed the story, but the game has a lot of issues that needs to be addressed. And I hope they did, but I haven't touched it since. Now, next up is actually a pretty interesting situation on how I achieved this Steelbook. So, I initially pre-ordered the game from GameStop, and I also pre-ordered the game at Best Buy, because I wanted the Steelbook, but the special edition at GameStop didn't even have a Steelbook. And I actually pre-ordered it for my girlfriend, so she has her own copy, but I have the Steelbook. And that is Resident Evil 3. And a lot of people hate this game, but I absolutely loved it. I really enjoyed it. It has its flaws, but I personally really enjoyed it. Next up is going to be Spider-Man. And, you know, what else is there to say about this game except that it's amazing? Next up is going to be Bayonetta and Vanquish. Now, Vanquish, I never even played or ever heard of until the Steelbook came out. I played it, and I actually really enjoyed it. And I think one day I definitely will stream this. Hopefully, maybe. Don't know yet. You know, it just depends on what the future entails, because there's something that happened recently that I haven't announced to you guys yet. So, yeah. Honestly, great game. and great game. Next up is actually not a steelbook I personally bought myself. This was actually my girlfriend's, and she gave it to me because she's not particularly a fan of the series. And that is Uncharted 4. And I ain't gonna lie, this steelbook looks really nice. I like it a lot. And personally, I really love the game. I think it's the best Uncharted game, in my personal opinion, right next to Uncharted 2. Next up is another game that came without a, you know, regular case, and that is Catherine. I tried to stream this for you guys, but of course, regulations. I streamed directly from the PS4 without any game capture device, and they blocked basically the last couple puzzles that leads to the ending. So, yeah, and just so you guys know, I got the good ending with this Catherine. So, yeah. Really enjoyed the game. It was my first time fully playing through it. I was introduced to it years ago, and this was my first time actually playing it myself. Last but not least is going to be Doom Eternal. Now, interestingly enough, I actually do have a regular case for this, but something happened to one of my other games. That case actually has a hole in it, so I took the disc out of that game, put it into the Doom Eternal case, put the Doom disc into this, since I had the steelbook, and now that disc is resting in that case on my shelf in the living room, and that disc is actually just a data disc for Cyberpunk 2077. So, that's why that wasn't part of the beginning of the list, or the beginning of the video. So that is going to be it for my video game steelbook collection. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys enjoy seeing the different steelbooks I actually do own. One day I will be doing a movie steelbook collection, and that is a pretty big collection compared to this. It's not that big, but it's definitely bigger than this. So until next time, I will see you guys again later.